Hi everyone, I'm Lakshmi MS from CSE department. Today I want to discuss about the book 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. I want to discuss on one habit. The habit is seek first to understand, then to be understood. This habit follows the principle of empathic communication. Empathic communication is a key to effective interpersonal communication. Communication is the most important skill in our life. We spend most of our hour in communicating, but when we consider, we spend lot of hour in learning how to write, read, and even in how to speak. But what about listening? No education or training has enabled an individual to understand a person in their own in their own perspective. When you want to effectively talk to a person, you should understand them in their unique situation. It is like you won't use this technique when you talk to a person, unless you understand them in their unique situation or feelings, you won't be able to advise them or counsel them. It is like they all have your words, but they can't trust your words. Most of the people do not listen to people in the instinct to understand. They actually listen in the instinct to reply. It is like they are actually speaking or preparing to speak. We have four different autobiographical responses. One is evaluating, the people actually judge and then agree or disagree. The second one is probing. They actually ask questions based on their own references. The third one is advising. They advise or counsel and solve a problem. The fourth one is interpreting. They analyze their motives, your motives and behavior based on their own experiences. Early Greeks have a magnificent philosophy. They actually use three words to describe empathic communication. The three words are ethos, pathos and logos. This ethos, pathos, logos follow the sequence of your character, your relationship and your presentation. When you actually do it, when you actually understand a person in their perspective, you actually develop a emotional bank account. It is like you can work together effectively. It is inside out approach. When you actually do it, when you understand a person from their perspective, you are influenceable. Being influenceable is the key of influencing others. I gonna conclude this by saying, when a problem comes to you, you should understand and analyze from their own perspective rather than analyzing and evaluating from your autobiographical. So develop this skill, this habit to be an effective person. Thank you.
I'm Divya from CSE department. Today I'm here to talk about the topic Think Win-Win, which is one of the 7 habits of highly effective people. Let us consider a situation. Whether you are a president or in a company or a janitor, you step into an interdependent life from an independent life. That means you automatically step into a leadership role. In that case, you are in a position of influencing others. Your character influences the other people. The effective habit of a leader or a leadership quality is think win-win. Win-win is not a technique, it's not a procedure, it's a human philosophy of human mutual interactions. Win-win is also one of the paradigms of the human interactions. Other interactions include win-lose, lose-win, lose-lose, win-win or no deal. Win-win is a frame of mind and heart that seeks mutual benefit from all human interactions. Win-win is also told as agreements or solutions for the problems that are mutually beneficial and mutually satisfying. It sees the life in a different perspective, that is, it sees the life as a cooperative arena instead of a competitive world. And it is also told as the success of a person cannot be determined by the expense or expulsion of the success of the other people. People always think in a way that with respect to destinies, like hardball or softball, weak or strong, and win or lose. But that kind of thinking is always not entertained and it is fundamentally flawed. In other way, there arises a question that which way is better, win, lose or which paradigm? But win-win is it's a third alternative paradigm. It's not that it's your way or my way, it just gives the idea of it's a better way, highly effective way. So depending on the situation and the circumstance and the way the other people think, we should always go in the right path. Hence, I would like to conclude by telling that win-win is the thing which makes the people in the cooperative or the corporate world feel good about themselves and make people accept the decisions, because win-win decision, win-win solutions are always accepted by the people, and the actions are always accepted by the people, and it is and the people get committed to it. Thank you.
Hi, this is Gayatri. I am from CSE department. Today I am going to talk about book that is written by 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, written by the Stephen Covey. Okay, I am going to talk one habit in that, that is nothing but synergize. Synergize is nothing but the principle of the creative cooperation. When properly understood that, synergize is the highest activity in all the life through trust and the manifestation of the all the other habits put together. The highest forms of the synergize focus the 4 unique human endowments, the motivation of a win-win and the skills of the empathetic communication and the thoughts challenging we face in life. Okay, what is the creativity process? The creativity process is almost terrifying part because we don't know exactly what's going on to happen or where going to be, and we don't know what new challenges we will face here. Okay, let us talk about the applications of the synergize. Think about a person who is typically sees things differently than you do. Okay, consider that the ways in which those differences might be used stepping stones to the third are attractive solutions. Make a list of people who is imitating you. Do you represent the different ways and views that could lead to synergize if you have had a great interactive security and values the differences? Thank you.
Hi, I'm Radha. I'm going to discuss about the topic 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, written with Stephen Covey. In that, I will be telling you about habit number 7, that is sharpen the saw. Sharpen the saw means to develop your brain faculties physically, socially, mentally and spiritually. It is continuous improvement habit in both the personal and interpersonal. The habit talks about balance and renew your resources, energy and health to create a sustainable long-time effective lifestyle. It primarily emphasizes exercise for physical renewal or meditation, yoga, etc. and good reading for mental renewal. It is also mentioned services to society for spiritual renewal. Stephen R. Covey explains upwards spiral model. In that, habits sharpening the saw. Along with your consistent progress, the spiral will result in growth, change, learn, commit and do. According to Stephen R. Covey, you must be increasingly educating the conscience in order to grow and develop an upward spiral. The idol of education will propel one along the path of personal freedom, security, wisdom and power. To keep watch of physical fitness, social, public relationing, acquiring knowledge, skill and aptitude, and concentrating selves to improve inner self. Providence has endowed the humans with numerous colors like a butterfly. He has to display these colors one by one after a series of hectic efforts to pass through the challenge of life, like a butterfly, which struggles to get out of a minor hole in coca. During this attempt, he gains strength in its feeble wings.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Lavanya from BSH department. Today I'm going to discuss about the topic 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. Among these habits, I would specifically like to talk about put first things first. Being the best creation of Almighty, you create many of the daily life but not life. By put first things first means that you have to lead a disciplined and organized life. Do not waste your energy on wasteful productivity. You must ensure that you deal with the things as these come before you. Do not disturb the flow and order of things. Say no when you feel things are getting disturbed and you are going out of schedule. Select your priorities and stick to those priorities. Thus, I conclude my speech by saying that if you are able to put first things first, you are saving time, cost and energy. It's all about planning and organizing life and its daily issues. Thank you.